Surround Lounge. In today's session, we are going to be talking about the sound-filled microphone, which makes use of ambisonics and is a very revered bit of kit in the field of recording. The reason for this is because inside the sound field there are four mics, three of which are figure-of-eight microphones, and one of which is an Omni. They are positioned equally around the a tetrahedral arrangement. This means that they equally capture each portion of the 3D surroundings of the mic. This allows them to capture acoustic information essentially perfectly, and which can then be recreated, which after all might as well be the point of recording in the first place for perfect reproduction. The sound field has a number of applications, but today we'll be looking at using all four of its internal tetrahedrally positioned mics to record B-format output. I was lucky enough to use the ST250, which I used for recording electric guitar. If you're worried about positioning your sound field or how to, don't be. It's equal in essentially every way, so you can, as long as you position it near or in a position where you want to capture the acoustic frequencies of your sound source, then it doesn't matter which way it's facing or is placed. It will, however, pick up everything from every direction, so you've got to make sure that there is no unwanted sounds occurring in the other direction from your sound source. The four outputs from the capsules within the microphone are known as A-format signals. These are sent through the sound field's dedicated control unit, from which you can change the settings and record in mono or stereo or even reenact the double midside with one microphone. The control unit converts the recordings into sound field B-format. Up on your screen right now is a handy diagram of the B-format signal's directional patterns. Look at that. From here you can see these contain information from all acoustic activity around the microphone, spanning depth, width and height for X, Y and Z respectively, which can each be thought of as a figure of eight microphone. So for example, Y spanning width, one side of the figure eight will cover left and the other will cover right. We'll go back to that. The fourth signal is an Omni, W, which measures pressure. Encoding B-format signals this way will provide enough information to place the sounds in one reference point, which is recreated as the listening point and is very close to where each of the mics are positioned in the first place, so there's some recalibration going on there. But don't worry about that, because that takes place in the dedicated control unit, very conveniently. The sound field part 2, the sequel, or more specifically, a lesson in ambisonics, is continued in the mixing section. Due to the mathematical nature of explaining ambisonics, it will be in text format. As always though, send us in your experiences with ambisonics or the sound filled mic to thesurroundlounge@gmail.com. It's a very exciting bit of kit. I hope you like it. Cheers.